Welcome to my restaurant application capstone presentation video. I'm going to go through the front end architecture, authorization, Stripe authorization, and my app diagram in this. So here in my app diagram, you can see that the client side is obviously the computer where we request to the server certain specific things from the website. Example, the restaurant query. So the server makes a request, the GraphQL can then query the fetch to the data from the backend, and then there's a JWT that's handed back and forth so you don't have to continuously log in. The server will make a mutate or a query fetch from the Postgres hosted on Render, and then return a payload JSON that the server can then parse and send to the client so he can see it on the application. Cloud and Area is hosting the images for Strapi so they're quickly loaded into the application. Vercel is hosting the front end website, and this is all coming from GitHub where you push for your repository all your code. The Strapi backend is API endpoints where restaurants can be fetched, dishes can be fetched, as well as orders and users. So here's a look at the front end code architecture. We basically have components. These will run the general forms, layout, navigation that the user will see eventually. This will have all the styling here. Also, we have app context, which is a centralized location webhook for React that we can pull information from throughout our app. Down here in the pages, these are the actual routes that Next.js has made up. So we have the app route. This is where we put our Apollo client and our GraphQL. As you can see, it's wrapped as the app provider. This is all done internally through Apollo client. Also, we have the index, which is basically the front HTML page that you would see, and it calls in the query for the restaurant list, which is right here. And this pulls in all the restaurants to the page. There's also utilities used for rendering, so it initializes the render each time. And this is basically our architecture for Next.js project. So here in the front end, you can see how easy it is to navigate around, do a few dishes very quickly, and back home. Add the cart, and you can see Next.js makes it super simple. This is the front end architecture in work. So showing Strapi's authentication route. These are rules that you place on individual items within the database, so a dish, the order, so you can create an order, and restaurant, so you can find them in the search query. So also, your users are authenticated here in the back end. You can see these are all the fake users that I made up on the app. So the authentication then goes back to the app. Okay, in the front end to checkout, we are going to use Stripe. And you can see in our checkout JS, we have Stripe load for its promise. Using its clear-cut elements and checkout form, you just have to pass the token through the developer in the back end. And you can see here on our developer's dashboard, you can see 7 successful payments throughout the course of the app. It gives you ways to actually activate your account, which I haven't done. And this just shows your